Here's how news people judge our news. Best. Eyewitness News judged Best Newscast by the Associated Press and judged Best Newscast by United Press International. The Eyewitness News team judged best in covering a breaking news story by AP and UPI. If you want the best, judge for yourself. TV5 Eyewitness News, the best way to get the news.
This is CBS.
Good evening, I'm Pam Martin.
And I'm Jim Axel. Tonight, hundreds pack the Civic Center downtown, sparks flying over plans to build the Presidential Parkway. Jim Kay has a live update. Douglasville residents out in force as well tonight, telling officials they are against plans for a landfill.
Ken Cook will tell us how long the new dry weather is going to be with us, and Corey McFerrin reports live on how the Braves blasted the Dodgers. It's all next on Eyewitness News Update.
Whiter wash. Add the final touch.
I'm going to try it.
Next, Atlanta's number one late newscast. This is Eyewitness News Update with Forrest Sawyer, Pam Martin, Ken Cook with weather, and Corey McFerrin with sports.
Good evening. Forrest Sawyer's on assignment. Douglasville residents tonight.
Proven success.
Five.
TV5 News Scene. The Atlanta News Team with Chuck Moore and Jackie Maddox. Superstar Sports with Harmon Wages. Guy Sharp with Color Radar Weather. Here's Chuck Moore.
Good evening. Here's what's happening. President Carter will receive a hero's welcome tonight when he returns to Washington in less than a brush fire in northwest Atlanta today.
And a young boy lost his life in a DeKalb County house fire. We'll have that and much more when News Scene returns.
That's what's happening. Stay tuned now for Barnaby Jones. For the News Scene team, I'm Chuck Moore. Good night.
Portions of News Scene have been brought to you by Food Giant and Big Apple.
Tonight on the CBS Late
Night belongs.
The following program is pre-recorded.
Five News Scene tonight with Chuck Moore, Pam Martin, and the News Scene team.
Good evening. Here's what's happening. A foreign exchange student from Tanzania attending a... And a look at the Atlanta Hawks playing the Cleveland Cavaliers tonight in St. Petersburg. Superstar Sports is next as News Scene moves along.
Good one.
That's what's happening. Stay tuned for Maud. For the News Scene team, I'm Chuck Moore. Good night.
Portions of News Scene have been brought to you tonight by Big Star Food Stores. Invite you to join us now for a moment of reflection.
When I was a young boy, I was intrigued by the 139th Psalm.
It's the policy employment opportunities to qualifiable applicants without regard to race, color, religion, sex, or national origin. This is WTCG Channel 17 Atlanta, an equal opportunity employer.
KHOU-TV, Houston. And now, from 11 News in Houston, Steve Smith, Marlene McClinton, Dr. Neil Frank with weather, and Gip Nielsen on sports. This is KHOU 11 News at 10.
Houston City Council volleys a plan to ban cigarette companies from...
KHOU TV in Houston. This is Channel 11 News at 5. with Felicia Jeter, Steve Smith, Dr. Neil Frank with the weather, and Kip Nielsen on sports.
And good afternoon on this rainy afternoon. Steve is off. I'm Sylvan Rodriguez. Another marathon session.
In the world. And what would you do if you were ever put in a situation where your every waking thought was nourishment? On the next Oprah Winfrey Show.
Watch the Oprah Winfrey Show Thursday at 4 on Channel 11.
We hope you'll join us tonight at 6 for 11 News.
This is the CBS Evening News, Dan Rattle reporting. Good evening. More on the Meese. Hello, buddy. This is the scene at 5, and the good news of the day is that the bluebonnets are coming out all over the place. Life as we know it is just about right on course. The eyes of the country on Memphis today as we mark the 20th anniversary of the death of Dr. Martin Luther King. We'll talk to the man who's accused of killing King and the Houston lawyer who defended him. Next on the scene at 5.
273-37.
Channel 2, KPRC-TV. This is The Scene at 5 with Ron Stone, Doug Johnson, and the Channel 2 News Team.
Hello, buddy. I'm Ron Stone. And I'm Doug Johnson, and this is The Scene at 5. 15 years ago, the first job we ever had as a team was on this program called The Scene at 5. We did it rather well, I think, for about 10 years, and then we were given other assignments.
Understanding can make a world of difference.
Jesse Jackson and General Noriega, confusion and controversy.
Play today, blockbuster video. Wow!
Este programa es transmitido simultáneamente en español.
KPRC-TV, Channel 2, Houston's 24-hour news channel. Now, Channel 2 News, Nightcast, with Bill Baeza, Doug Johnson, Craig Roberts, and the Channel 2 News team.
Good evening, folks. More than 30 middle school students went to the hospital this afternoon after their school bus was hit head-on. Two people...
This is News 7 with Chris Gordon and Paul Berry.
Good evening. For the first
strip for the first time in 27 years. And there will soon be a new face behind the mask of Batman.
Good evening. I'm John McKnight.
And I'm Cheryl Case. Those stories right now on Atlanta's News at 10.
From WGNX Channel 46. This is Atlanta, Georgia's award-winning News at 10.
O.J. Simpson shows a grim reaction in court today to testimony about the bloody corpse of his ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, the woman he is accused of murdering. It has been a day of dramatic testimony.
With an added touch of mystery concerning evidence turned over to the judge in Simpson's preliminary hearing.
From Atlanta, this is WGNX News Tonight.
Left center field, Grissom on the run. The team of the 90s has its world championship.
After 30 years, tonight is the night. The Atlanta Braves, the new world champions. Good evening, I'm John McKnight.
And I'm Cheryl.
Adult reaction tonight on a judge's ruling in the case of the Heritage High School shooting suspect, T.J. Solomon. CBS Atlanta News starts right now.
From CBS Atlanta, WGNX 46. This is CBS Atlanta News at 11.
Horns honked madly in Midtown Atlanta this evening as people took to the streets in support of the rights of pedestrians. Drivers stopped, but tempers flared over a law that seems to be foreign to Atlanta motorists. Good evening. I'm Andrea Arsenault. Karen Greer is off tonight.
I'm John McKnight. Atlanta has one of the worst records in the country for hit-and-run driving accidents and fatalities.
Next, we'll see you tomorrow. Good night.
From CBS Atlanta, WGNX 46. This is CBS Atlanta News at 6.
Tonight, keeping a closer eye on hate groups as we learn new details about the gunman who attacked a Jewish community center in Los Angeles. Good evening. Karen's off tonight. I'm John McKnight.
And I'm Mike Stevens.
Body's worst brush fire in 5 years. It forces people from their homes tonight. CBS Atlanta News starts right now.
From CBS Atlanta, WGNX 46. This is CBS Atlanta News at 11.
Really bad.
Tonight, the Empire State is feeling the powerful winds and punch of Tropical Storm Floyd. He's dancing along the northeast, dropping lots of rain. And here at home, it's rain firefighters needed for this brush fire that forced 20 families out of their homes in Paulding County. Good evening, everyone. I'm Calvin Hughes.
And I'm Jane Robillo. More on that brush fire in just a moment. But first, the whereabouts of Tropical Storm Floyd. It is day three of deliberation.
Schools in Atlanta claim victim after victim to the teen pregnancy epidemic. What man works daily with a growing Georgia problem? And who are victims? Ron Saylor gives you some answers tonight on Our Children's Children. A special assignment next on Channel 2's Action News. From WSB-TV, Georgia's news leader, Monica Kaufman, Don Farmer, Glenn Burns weather, and Chuck Dowdle on sports. This is Channel 2's Action News.
Tonight, full PTL coverage. Reverend Jerry Falwell turns on the heat, and it's Jim Baker who gets burned.
Also tonight, where is Jim Baker? We'll go live to his home in Palm Springs to find out if we can.
And we'll hear from Baker's followers. How do they feel about today's PTL shakeup?
And that's our top story tonight, a shakeup at PTL.
Live.
Alabama, Skylink 6, Channel 6 News, Secrets on 6.
Hey.
For years, putting children first has been a priority at Channel 6. We've tried to address the issues that help a child learn and keep on learning. We've met with parents, educators, and business leaders, and one message is clear. The hope for our kids lies in the strength of our families. Step by step, we can all make a difference. In coming months, WBRC will continue to share advice from experts on ways we can all put family first.
Buffalo Rock and Channel 6 are proud to bring you Family First.
If you want news and weather first thing in the morning, Channel 6 has what you're looking for. An hour of CNN headline news beginning at 4:30, then Channel 6 News Daybreak. World, national, and local news, plus your local weather forecast. Everything you need to know before you head out the door. CNN and Channel 6 News Daybreak, weekdays starting at 4:30.
Here's what's happening in our community from Channel 6, your 24-hour news team.
It's 10 o'clock. Do you know where your children are?
A former Alabama senator pleads guilty to taking $15,000 in state money.
And two suspects in the robbery of an armored car are behind bars while the search for the missing $1.7 million continues. These are two of our top stories this Tuesday, January 2nd.
From Channel 6, your 24-hour news team, this is Channel 6 News at 10.
Good evening, I'm Art Franklin.
And I'm Brenda LeDunn. Thanks for joining us tonight. He's not buying it, and a federal judge slams the door on a quick release of two Wells Fargo employees involved in what may be the heist of the year. New at 10 tonight.
Part of Alabama's 24-hour news team.
She leaves wreckage and death in her wake, and even though Fran is no longer a hurricane, the storm continues to threaten people.
Also, he murdered once. Now the warden says he's killed again. But this time, David Leitner is his own victim in an apparent jailhouse suicide. These are two of our top stories this Friday, September 6th.
From Fox 6, Alabama's 24-hour news team, this is Fox 6 News at 5.
Good evening.
We are currently experiencing difficulty with the NBC television network reception.
Please stand by. We'll remedy the situation as soon as possible. We are currently having network difficulty. Please stand by.
Ladies and gentlemen, President and General Manager of CBS 42, Eric Land.
We are committed to doing the right things. We're committed to doing the right things right all the time.
10, 9.
Doing the right things.
7.
In the right place.
5.
And at the right time.
3.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's about time.
This is 42 Daily News at 5. It's about time.
Check out this huge fire. Flames swallow 4 homes, but you've got to stick around to find out what makes this story even more incredible. Good evening, I'm Keith Pink.
And I'm Sherry Jackson. The sign reads, "This clinic stays open." Just 1 week after the bombing, the new woman all-women clinic reopens its doors. Plus, find out how man's best friend may help people suffering from a life-threatening blood disease.
And seems like every corner of the U.S. is getting hit hard by weather. So what's in store for Alabama? Also, this is not a famous cathedral, but it sure resembles one. They call it ice imitating art. This is 42 Daily News at 5. We will not be terrorized. Those words tonight from the owner of the New Woman All Women's Healthcare Clinic.
WBMG TV 42, The Look of Birmingham.
Sandy's got
a Look of Birmingham, WBMG Channel 42. Is WBMG TV, Birmingham 42 in stereo. Birmingham's news for the 90s. Catherine G., Barbara Boulding, meteorologist Fred Barnhill, and Doug Bell Sports. This is WBMG Action News 42, Night Desk.
Anything that offers to be 100 to 1,000 times more effective.
Loves to get us to give a lot.
There has to be an easier way.
From small irritations to major hassles, you're not alone. Tell 42 Daily News what bothers you. We'll investigate and share the answers.
It's about time.
Call the It's About Time line at 322-4200 with your concerns. Or visit our website at WIAT.com.
Time.
Fast, no-nonsense solutions designed to save you time. 42 Daily News. It's about time.
C6 News with news anchor Bill Bolin, Colleen Bates in the Weather Center, and Tom York with sports.
Good afternoon, shortly before. That's
the noon edition of BRC 6 News. For Tom York and Colleen Bates, I'm Bill Bolin. Reminding you, BRC 6 News continues this afternoon at 5 and at 6 p.m. Have a good afternoon.
Of course, her will have the latest on the Birmingham Stallions premiere performance.
So see you tonight at 10.
BRC 6 News Nightcast at 10 is news with the anchor team of Joe Langston and Scott Richards. For all the changes in tomorrow's forecast, there's weather with meteorologist Mike Royer and a full sports roundup with Herb Winches. A fresh look at the big stories of the day and the stories that'll make headlines tomorrow. Plus special in-depth cover stories on the issues that affect you. It's BRC 6 News Nightcast, weeknights at 10 o'clock with Joe, Scott, Mike, and Herb. Watch it.
Is BRC 6 News with news anchor Bill Bolin, Colleen Bates in the Weather Center, and Tom York with sports. This is BRC 6 News with the anchor team of Scott Richards and Bev Montgomery, meteorologist Mike Royer, and Mike Hogwood with sports. Is BRC 6 News with the anchor team of Joe Langston and Bev Montgomery, meteorologist Mike Royer, and Herb Winches with sports. From BRC 6 News, this is Nightcast with the anchor team of Joe Langston and Scott Richards, meteorologist Mike Royer, and Herb Winches with sports.
This is BRC 6 News with news anchor Janet Hall, Mary Brown in the Weather Center, and Ron Grillo with sports. This is a special report from BRC 6 News with Joe Langston.
This is Newswatch 13, the 6 p.m. report. The news with Kent Snow and Pam Huff. Gary Sanders with the sports. And the weather with Rosemary Lucas.
Good evening, President.
That's our news for now. We thank you for watching and ask that you stay tuned for the debut of a new show, Friday Live. Tonight you're going to get to see some new faces and talk with them.
And right now we thank you for watching. For Pam Huff, Rosemary Lucas, and Gary Sanders, I'm Ken Snow. We'll see you again at 10.
Stay tuned for Friday Live next on 13. Channel 13, Alabama's leading news station, this is Action News 13 with Ken Snow, Pam Huff, Scott Palmer, and James Spann.
That's our news for tonight. We thank you for watching. See you again at 10. Let's watch NBC Nightly News now.
Well, Tom, it's midweek. What's happening in sports?
Well, as you know, Bill, on Wednesday, not much happens in the way of hard news in sports, so I'm going to talk about computers.
What in the world has that got to do with sports, Tom?
Well, more and more, beginning to be just about everything in sports.
All right. I'll be anxious to hear.
Okay, I'll have the details of that in just a moment.
Is it time for us to get those umbrellas out?
I'm afraid it is. Looks like it's going to be moving in later in the afternoon. Not a very nice evening for trick-or-treating, I'm afraid, but we'll have details right after this.
That's the noon edition of Total News. This is Bill Bolin for Tom York and Donna Hamilton reminding you that Total News will continue this afternoon at 5:30, and we hope you have a pleasant afternoon.
In the past 25 minutes, you've seen the end product of the Action News team, but this is only the tip of the iceberg. So tonight, Jerry Hayes begins a five-part look behind the scenes at Action News 19.
News is a four-letter word, but it's not a 9-to-5 job. It's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. A typical day here at the Action News 19 newsroom begins about the same time the sun comes up.
Linda Crosby is the first news person on the job. The first thing she does is to check the wire machines to see what has happened in the world while all of us in the Tennessee Valley were catching 40 winds. Oh yes, she does something else very important for the newsroom. She makes the first pot of coffee. That's Bob Knowles. He's our assignment editor. You can see where he's headed. After Bob gets that first sip, he begins planning our day. He'll decide which stories we'll cover and which photographer and reporter will get the assignment. Just about the time Bob and Linda finish off the first pot of coffee, the rest of us arrive at work. While we're getting our first shot of morning caffeine, our news director Dan Cooper is busy discussing a story with 19's troubleshooter Keith Elkins. The rest of us are busy getting our day mapped out.
Hey, we're going to do the parade even though it's consumer education.
Oh, okay.
The closing.
Kind of depends on how you roll it out.
On the other end of the newsroom, our photographers are busy making sure they have all of their equipment, all 50 pounds of it. Camera, video recorder, microphones, batteries, lights, tapes, and of course, a strong back. We use the latest in electronic news gathering equipment. We refer to it as EMG. It's a major investment for news coverage. Each unit costs $30,000. We have five of them. Well, Dick Curtis has gotten his assignment, and he's ready to go get the story. We'll take you out in the field with him, but that's in tomorrow night's report. The coffee pot? Well, it's still on and will be all day. I'm Jerry Hayes, reporting from behind the scenes at Action News 19.
That coffee pot is still there, so hurry up with the weather app.
It could use it. Every time I go over to it, it's empty.
When Jerry Hayes left you last night, the coffee pot was warm and Dick Curtis and Glenn Hill were ready to cover Governor James at a convention. Here's part two of Behind the Scenes at Action News 19.
Dick and Glenn are on their way to interview the governor. He's in town to talk to a group of elementary educators. Usually, the reporter and photographer will discuss the story before they get there. That way, the photographer will know what the reporter wants in the way of pictures to tell his story. But not everything discussed is business.
Why don't you go out to this next story and I'll stay in the warm, dry car, okay? Sound like a good deal?
Yeah, I don't have enough.
You're a pushover.
Not everything goes as planned. The governor is an hour late and doesn't have time for an interview. So Dick tries to talk with him as they walk down the hallway.
What are you going to talk about today?
Talk about elementary education and the facets and the work of the school board, state school board.
Dick decides he'll have to get the story as the governor speaks. While Dick takes notes, Glenn shoots what we call cover footage. These are the pictures you see while Dick tells the story. After they get all of the footage they need and Dick has all the facts to put his story together, he decides to do a stand-up. This is when you see the reporter standing in front of the camera telling you something about the story. And we don't always get it right the first time.
Okay, so Governor James today said the 8 point... No, it's 15. 15%. Start again. So Governor James today said the 15% increase in the state revenue could give teachers a raise.
After he gets this done, he's ready to go back to the station and put his story together. But first, he checks in with the newsroom to see if any other stories have developed. Bob says nothing is happening. He tells Dick it's okay to eat lunch. Since we're on the road so much, we seldom have time to take a real lunch hour. We usually eat on the run. That means a burger, some fries, and a Coke. Not your most nourishing meal, but it does fill an empty spot. By now, most of the reporters are busy writing their stories. Tomorrow night, we'll show you what we have to go through to get our reports on the air. I'm Jerry Hayes, reporting from behind the scenes at Action News 19.
Action News 19. There's more to a news story than the 2 minutes you see on your television set. In fact, a lot of people have to do a lot of things to get that 2 minutes on the air. Tonight, Jerry Hayes starts getting into the nitty-gritty of our day at Action News 19.
Hey, Jerry, it's going to go in the final segment, and I can let you have 2:15.
No more?
I can make it 2 if you want.
No, it's okay. Before any reporter begins writing their story, we have to talk to our producer, Michael Lamont. We discuss the story, what it's about, where it's going to fit in the newscast, and how much time it warrants. We are faced with problems like trying to tell about the governor's visit in a minute and a half, although he was here for 2 hours. By 2:30, the race against our biggest enemy, the clock, is underway. That's about the same time our late shift comes into work.
Action News 19, Missing Men, can I help you?
Don, can you let me 45 seconds of this freight train here?
Sure. The newsroom has become a beehive. By now, all three of our editing booths are being used. Dick is busy working on his report about the governor's visit. Steve Johnson is putting a sports story together. And Alice Hargrove is working on her report. This is about the time our technical director, Paul Hussel, comes in. He's a guy that pushes the buttons during the newscasts. Michael is trying to shoehorn in all the news, weather, and sports into 30 minutes. Paul is working on the technical aspects of the show.
From Washington, this is the CBS Evening News with Walter Cronkite.
Good evening.
That means we have 30 minutes before we go on the air. Tomorrow night, we'll take you in the studio with our anchor team and in the control room to show you what goes on behind the cameras. It's different from what you see on your TV screen. I'm Jerry Hayes reporting from behind the scenes at Action News 19.
You know, I think we're giving away all our secrets.
Boy, I'll say it. I'll say it.
This week, Jerry Hayes has shown you a typical day around Action News 19, and in tonight's story, he takes you behind the scenes as the clock ticks towards 6.
The last few minutes before we go on the air are the most hectic. That's when we put the final touches on the show, making sure scripts are in order, tapes have been edited, and getting pretty for the camera. While Missy puts on some final touches, across the hall, Tom Kinnemer makes up two. Yes, we guys have to wear it, too. It helps cut down on glare caused by the bright studio lights. It makes us look a little better, too. When Tom, Missy, and Steve walk into the studio, Dan Maley is still putting the final touches on his weather map. In the control room, the producer, director, and engineers are making last-minute checks.
The sports quiz is centered. Of course, I forgot to write that down. And the sports quiz is centered.
We had the two shots in the first.
Yeah, we
got
two shots on four.
Number four.
We got two shots, I believe, on nine.
All right, second segment. Is that all right?
Yeah, second.
Okay.
Stand by.
WHNT Television, Channel 19, Huntsville.
When the cameras come on, decisions are still being made here in the booth. It's like a three-ring circus. Engineers are busy queuing up the next story.
Well, all of us may have a problem later this week. The State Dairy Commission is meeting on Thursday. It may raise the price of milk. Bob Knowles reports.
In 30 minutes, we tell you what happened in the world of news, what the weather is going to be tomorrow, and who the number one team in college football is. It's these 30 minutes that make it all worthwhile when we come into your homes and tell you what has happened during the day.
And that's our news for now.
Thank you very much for being with us, and good evening.
When it's all over, the studio lights are turned off, the director scripts are tossed into the can, and the news people go back to the newsroom. But while the news day has ended for some, it's only half over for others. There's still the 10 o'clock newscast to put together. That means updating stories and showing you some new events, too. Tomorrow night, we'll show you how it differs from what you see at 6. I'm Jerry Hayes, reporting from behind the scenes at Action News 19.
Well, last night you saw what happens behind the scenes during this broadcast, but news is a 24-hour-a-day business. Things are just getting started at 6:30. Here's Jerry Hayes' final report behind the scenes at Action News 19.
By the time most of us have put in our 9 to 10 hours, we're ready to go home and relax. But the news doesn't stop just because it's 6:30. The late crew is already working on the 10 o'clock newscast. One of our producers, Don Leffler, spends his afternoon looking at what's happening on the national scene. Don reads the wire copy, takes the afternoon network news feed, and watches Cronkite and Company at 5:30. Meanwhile, Tom and Missy are deciding which local stories to cover, such as the city council or the school board meeting. They'll also be busy updating the major stories from the early news. Back in the studio, Dan Maley is already updating the weather forecast, and Steve Johnson is busy editing a new sports story. The idea is to give 10 o'clock a whole new look.
The Associated Press handed out its awards for news excellence. We were competing against other television stations in Birmingham, Montgomery, Huntsville, and Mobile. We're proud to say that TV6 was the big winner, receiving the lion's share of the awards. And we thought you'd like to see why the judges like Total News. Last November, Sally Wiggin put together a five-part series called Is Your Marriage on the Rocks? This piece of journalism helped out a lot of people, and the judges said it was the best television series aired in Alabama during 1979. Hurricane Frederick was big news all over the country when it ravaged the coast of Alabama. We sent Tim Larson and Norman Arnett to Mobile to cover the story. The Associated Press judges said their work was the best of any TV station in the state covering a breaking news story. Weather is more than just a hurricane. It's tornadoes. And is it going to rain on the picnic? There are lots of TV weathercasters in the state, but the AP judges said TV6's Mike Royer is the best. Sports in this state is Alabama and Auburn football, the Bulls, Little Leaguers, and how to improve your game of tennis, golf, or racquetball. Total News' Herb Winches covers the sports scene and reports it better than anyone else in the state. That is not only our opinion, but also those of the Associated Press judges. Total News is popular with you and the judges. At 5:30 and at 10, more people are watching Total News than the other television stations combined. After viewing all the TV news shows in the state, the judges said Total News with Joe Langston, Herb, and Mike is the best news program in Alabama. This program wouldn't have won the awards without the hard work and dedication of reporters, photographers, producers, assignment editor, directors, and engineers. We'll be trying even harder this year, not so we can get more awards, but so you'll get the most complete news, sports, and weather coverage possible. I'm John Hayes.
WAFF, Huntsville, Decatur.
Good afternoon. I'm Jack Robertson. We hope you'll stay with us for a full hour of news, starting next with NBC Nightly News, and then it's News 48. As you can see, we've made a couple of changes on our set here in the studio. You'll get... And, of course, we'll also tell you what's been going on in the news.
Receiving the coveted Pacemaker Award for leadership and excellence in broadcast journalism. That excellence extended to our newscast, which was voted the top regularly scheduled small market newscast in the state of Alabama. Our coverage of the news rated top honors. Bill Donaldson's coverage of the shooting of a Georgia trucker's wife was named the top spot news story in Alabama. Frank O'Neill won the top feature award for his report on the fledgling suntan parlor industry in Tuscaloosa. Our anchor people were also judged the tops in their class. Tina Hartman, our 6 o'clock news anchor, and producer and host of Kaleidoscope, was named the top news anchor for 1979. Fred Hunter took top award for the best sports anchor, and Frank O'Neill was named the state's top small market weatherman.
And that is the early edition of Eyewitness News. For Carla Green, Tom Stipe, and Frank O'Neill, I'm Dick Deason. Thank you for watching, and have a pleasant evening.
I keep my eyes.
Keep your eyes.
On Eyewitness News.
I keep my eyes.
Keep your eyes.
On Eyewitness News.
They give me sports and weather information I use.
Keep your eye on Eyewitness News.
I keep my eyes.
Keep your eyes.
Keep your eye
on Eyewitness News.
They tell me everything I need, so how can you lose?
Keep your eye on us at 11, 6, and 10.
Just keep your eye,
keep your eye
on Eyewitness News.
Keep your eye
on Eyewitness News. We give you sports and weather information you use. Keep your eye. Just keep your eye,
your eye
on Eyewitness News.
Keep your eye,
your eye on Eyewitness News. We tell you everything you need, so how can you lose?
Keep your eye.
Keep your eye on us at 11, 6, and 10.
Over a century ago, getting news from the Pony Express rider was getting it firsthand.
Found gold, California!
An eyewitness to an event that altered our country's future. Being there is a must for accuracy. It makes the difference. Pam Huff makes the difference. Just as the Pony Express rider made the difference in keeping our country in communication, Pam Huff makes the difference in news. Pam Huff, bringing it all home to you like nobody else. Time was, the best weatherman a person could have was the Pony Express rider.
Blizzard's coming!
Having the right information at the right time makes the difference. James Spann has the right information, firsthand. Just as early settlers trusted the Pony Express riders, the people of this area have learned to trust James Spann over any other forecaster. James Spann, bringing it all home to you like nobody else. The Pony Express rider, a man committed to his work, keeping our country in communication. When your responsibility is this great, you make a commitment. The same commitment Ken Snow makes when he covers the news. His ability and certainty make the difference. Just as this man's commitment kept our country informed, Ken Snow's commitment is to keep you informed. Ken Snow, bringing it all home to you like nobody else.
And this is an extra special day on the morning show. Today, we're very happy and pleased to introduce the newest addition to the morning show. Joining the morning show as co-hostess is a delightful young lady named Colleen Bates, and we'd like you to welcome her now. Good morning, Colleen. How are you?
I'm all right.
It is very nice to meet you and nice to have you on this show. I have met you earlier, of course, but they have not met you earlier, and we'd like to introduce you to all the people out there, and there are a bunch of them who are going to be watching this morning.
Good.
A lot of your friends, too.
I know.
You know, and they're going to call you and tell you about it. Colleen is from Cedartown, Georgia,
originally.
And you've been working for my friend Ed Bowell for some time now.
For about a year, about.
In the recording business.
Mm-hmm.
And you have experience as an actress.
A lot of that. And some radio work. Done some radio work.
And was I right when I said you played the trombone?
I did play the trombone, as a matter of fact. I played it for 9 years, as a matter of fact, in high school and college.
And she was also an alumnus of Jacksonville State University.
Playing the band there.
All right, we've got lots of things that we're going to talk to Colleen about, but I think it's important that we get to the news this morning. I'll have the sports and weather. And over there in the official news area, news department, Total News family member, Bill Boland.
Welcome, Colleen, to the show.
AD election tonight at 6:30 here on TV6. Well, Bill Boland, may I introduce you to Colleen Bates.
Good morning, Colleen Bates.
Good morning, Bill.
And welcome to this morning.
How about that? Let's do like they do. What is it at the... there we go. Now the Six family is ready to go. All right. Colleen, it is a pleasure to welcome you to the morning show.
Well, thank you. Certainly
a month ago, Colleen had no idea that, obviously, that she would be doing something like this. But when the call came out for auditions, she responded, and beautifully, I might add.
Well, thank you. Thank you. It's the first time I'd ever seen a television camera.
At the audition. Well, you're going to see a bunch of...
They said, watch the red light. So I watched the red light.
She's an actress, Bill. You're in a play now, aren't you?
Yes. Can I say where?
Where? Why don't you say where?
It's at Birmingham Festival Theater. It's called The Real Inspector Helm. And it's more or less a parody on a British murder mystery, kind of like a parody on an Agatha Christie.
Oh, okay.
Show.
Sounds very interesting.
It's tongue-in-cheek, melodramatic, and to do all those things I always wanted to do. My hand over my heart.
Well, we also said you were a musician, too. You played in the band when you were in high school and college.
Yes, and college. Carried that trombone in my hand and marched in snow and sleet and rain and heat.
Well, you're the only one on this show with any talent. I'm on for something.
It's in retirement.
It's in retirement.
It's on my wall.
Forever? Forever. We might coax it
maybe,
out of the mic.
Maybe.
May I add, Tom, that of course Colleen's been kind of understudying up here and observing for a couple of weeks, and so we've come to know Colleen, and she's a very warm and friendly person, which has impressed me a lot, and I think this will come over as we go along, but it will be a real answer to his mission.
Thank you.
Well, you know, one of the things that we're looking for when you're looking for someone to replace somebody on television or to be on a show is being pleasant. Attitude and being pleasant is very, very, very important. You won't know how important that is until you've gotten into the business. And I went to a going, and I will tell you this, that I know we were right in our selection. Because I went to a going away party for Colleen at Bowell Studios the other day. And I have never seen anybody cry such big crocodile tears in my life at losing a favored employee.
Yeah. So
they're great people.
But Ed was very magnanimous about it, says, go on, get out of here.
He said they wrote me off. They wrote me songs, so they wrote me off.
They wrote songs, Bill, first of all, somebody had arranged for the
Live Wires
in and sing a real catchy little ditty about her. Yeah.
You call them up with the details, and they write a song.
Yeah.
They wrote 5 or 6 verses, and they come in costumes, with clown costumes and big noses. come
and
in.
They were very, very witty, very, very clever. And then the one thing that I liked, that the crew down there that parodied the song, "You Picked a Fine Time to Leave Me," Lucille, and they just substituted Colleen.
Colleen, eh?
Picked a fine time to leave us, Colleen. And by the time they got through with that and got, all the hugging, and Colleen was getting a little teary-eyed at the moment. But we're glad to have you with us, and
I
know you're going to miss
here.
The folks. Which you're not very far from. Just
I'll go see them. Yeah. They better call
me. Hula hoop down the road.
Not far at all. Not far.
But we're delighted to have you with us, and
I'm delighted to be here.
Colleen will be doing the weather. She'll be doing interviews. She'll be doing the co-hostess job on the morning show. And there are many times when she will be doing the show by herself. In a few short weeks, she will be doing just that. And I guess we better move along here. What's happening? Well, the last feature I had scheduled this morning, we're just going to forego, and we're going to sit here and talk to Colleen a little bit. We talked about not a whole bunch of things this morning, but you, Colleen, by the way, will be doing the weather very shortly. And she has been...
When I learned the states.
they don't have
the names on them.
It's difficult out there in the West where they have no names on them.
It's the New England states that are
New England?
Just, yes.
Well, I can get those. The ones out in the West are scattered around like the big ones.
I've traveled up through the West and the Midwest out there, but I haven't been much in New England, and I can't really.
New Hampshire, Vermont, and Maine, and Massachusetts, and yeah, I don't know. Well,
you know.
Anyway, but you're learning a little bit from our resident meteorologist, Mike Royer. Huh?
I understand that he knows everything there is to know.
Everything you need to know about weather,
but we're afraid to ask.
And never wanted to know, as a matter of fact. Now, Mike is very excellent in his production of the weather programs here on TV6, and Colleen is tutoring under him right now. And Donna Hamilton is also passing along some information.
Mm-hmm. She's very polished. She scares me. She's just so polished with our newscast.
Oh, she's
weathercast.
A very talented young lady.
Yeah.
She's been doing it for quite a long while now. But you will be equally as adept at doing it within a short time.
Our faith.
Promise. All right, the show we're spotlighting in Lorch's Diamond Jubilee is the 80 vote at 6:30 tonight, and I'll have our final call in just a moment. Colleen, your first day was a smash.
Well, thank you.
Your second day will be better. Tomorrow, join us at 7 o'clock for the morning show. In the meantime, as we always say, stay cool.
In Birmingham, this is TV6.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the morning show, a misty look at downtown Birmingham. This is Monday, August the 11th, sort of an historical day for me and for this morning show. Since November 1957, this morning show began at 7 o'clock. Now a new era begins, maybe for another 23 years. This will not be a new show. This will be, there will be some new features, but essentially the only change will be the time. And I hope you enjoyed Good Morning America this morning, and that you'll continue with us here on the morning show, which will be more like Good Morning Alabama. Also, only this time it means Good Morning Alabama. Our regulars, of course, will continue to be with us. Colleen Bates will bring you the weather and much, much more, with features and interviews here and in the studio and on location, too. And Bill Bolin will be here with headlines and national and local news. So it's the same team with new directions and a different hour from 8 to 9.
I like 8 to 9 myself.
Do you like music?
Yeah,
well,
like
good. Do a little talking here this morning with Colleen and Bill. We got a new set.
Yeah.
Brand new stuff like that. And beautiful new coffee cups.
this is the most avant-garde part of the coffee cups.
These are decorator plastic.
I think.
Or something like that. But we are going to enjoy them. We are going to have I said earlier it's going to be many of the same features that we've had, but we're going to have a little more time to do some outside work. And Bill, you're going to have...
I kind of have a 50-50 split of the news at 8:25.
Yeah.
It's at 8:30, I can't remember.
8:25.
We got to get it all in my head, but we'll kind of give a little of Alabama, a little of national headlines to keep everybody right up to the date.
And Colleen, of course, you have a feature this morning about Homewood Band going to camp, and you've done that yourself many times, so you can relate to that, can't you?
Right.
Also, we'll have an advantage of taking our remote bus out and doing several remote interviews and features at various places around the city and around the state, too. So we're going to hopefully bring you some interesting features of that nature. But in a few moments, Colleen will have her first feature, which is featuring the Homewood Band, right after this. Well, how did you like the Shakedown Cruise? How did you like the original voyage?
I felt like today was rehearsal, you know?
Yeah, I did too. No, rehearsal went a lot better.
I did it, yeah.
20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, and we're going to come up for air tomorrow morning. I hope you will join us. We'll try to have some fun for you, some information for you every day here on the morning show from 8 to 9. Stay tuned now for Merv Griffin. Have a good day.
Well, good morning. We're back. The time is just about 10 minutes after 8. The show we're spotlighting on the Lorch's Diamond Jubilee is The Heroes of Rock and Roll at 8 o'clock. I chose that one myself.
You're such a talented little
Yes, I know. Aren't
that?
I, though?
We get out all by ourselves. No help from anybody.
Well, that's right. I guess you all recognize this lady to my right here, Donna.
Barely.
She has been here before many times.
And I, I was not sitting so far away that I missed that chunky remark.
Well, let's face it. I won't ask you to stand up and embarrass yourself, but it's a fact of life. She's put on a couple of pounds. Come on now. It's normal. It's to be expected.
It happens, Donna.
And you are, I would characterize you as chunky.
Yeah, I get up early to come up here and everybody's around and insults me.
No, I would.
Life, Donna.
If you hadn't given any break, we would be a little upset, wouldn't we?
I guess you're right.
How much is normal to put on? I won't ask you how much you put on, but how much
Thank you. I really appreciate that, Samson.
How much is normal? So you can see that chemistry
really,
working now.
He is about
you?
To step in it today.
Now, how much weight is normal?
You know, you and I have to work together.
Yes. It's not work.
Yeah. They say now 25 pounds. Mm-hmm. They used to say 20, I think. But I like 25. It better than 25.
You
have a little leeway.
But you've not blimped out like Phyllis George did. Phyllis George is the size of a Buick. She really put
you.
On some weight.
Thank you, Mike.
You look much better.
I'll consider that a real compliment.
Is this what goes on between you two all the time when you're, this the kind of...
No, he seems to be in rare form this morning.
It's because it's Monday morning and he's not awake.
Suppose.
He's doing it in his sleep. Well, you two are working together now, and tell us what it is that you are working on.
Working on PM Magazine. We really have, and truly, we've been working very, very hard.
I've heard some strange tales of some of the places that you've come in from the field, as it were, literally, I think, sometimes, of what you've been doing.
Yeah, Mike, in fact, was working night before last on the Drum and Bugle Corps.
We were out till 1.
Did it rain on you out there?
No. And then Donna was out the night before that. We're working late.
On the Tough Guy contest, which was...
That's where anybody who wants to can get up and box.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I can truly say that was a unique experience, going to that thing. Yeah, a huge crowd there. I was surprised. A lot of people.
Were they bloodthirsty?
Everybody wanted to see it. Were they what?
Bloodthirsty?
The crowd?
Yes.
Yeah, more so than the boxers, I think.
The boxer
really,
they got
they really were.
Thing, blood.
Now you see, that's just one of the interesting
really
things
true.
That you'll learn on PM Magazine.
Hey, I can't wait.
But we really have, we've gone all over the state. Mike's done a feature up in Huntsville. Mm-hmm. I've gone down to Biola Battery at the other end of the state. So you'll probably see our little brightly colored, I think we could safely call that a brightly colored van.
With Spiffy is what it is.
Magenta, red, and orange with PM on it.
I saw it parked on Valley Avenue the other day, but I won't ask why. Or it was in front of one of those, maybe I shouldn't say it, maybe it wasn't supposed to be there.
I think we were out getting a hamburger then.
I don't know.
Probably so.
Something mundane like that.
So we have lots of good stuff coming up. Boy, is it going to be a good show.
Can you tell us when it premieres? When is the...
September 8th.
Yeah.
It's not very far.
Mm-hmm.
And what time?
6:30.
What time of day or night does it come on?
6:30 in the evening.
Oh, good.
It will follow Tic-Tac-Toe.
Right.
And it will be on Monday through Friday.
And is it a 30-minute or an hour show?
A 30-minute.
30 minutes.
Oh, that's still a lot of work. It's all features, though,
minutes.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Action-packed.
That's right. Action-packed and self-help. And we've got a good supporting cast with us. We've got some famous people on there.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, we do.
Who?
We have Donna and me, first of all.
Of course. Well,
yeah,
that goes without saying.
Well, we have a lot of people you've seen on television before. We have Joan Embry from the San Diego Zoo, who's been on TV a lot with Strange Animals. Blonde, cute, she's going to be with us. And we have
People that will be becoming famous to them anyway.
We have a plant expert
Chef
on.
Tell.
Jerry Baker. We have Captain Carrot. He has my favorite name in all of the world.
Captain Carrot.
Yep.
Chef Tell's my favorite.
I'm already so informed that I don't know if I can stand it. I'll have to wait till we ingest all this information before the
Captain Carrot will talk to us. Maybe every now and then he'll talk to us about things that can make you strong or things that will keep you fit. And Chef Tell has some cooking, and Jerry Baker talks plants, and we have...
Are these regular features?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we will hear from Chef Tell and Captain Carrot all the time.
Constantly. You can't shut them up.
No way.
They're what they call the departments. The show is formatted so that you have about a 6.5-minute feature on either end of the show, which are longer features, more in-depth things on whatever you're covering, whether it be a specific person or an event. Then in the middle, they have their departments, and those are what they call tips on... the things that Mike was talking about, their home and cooking and food and health and travel and just about everything.
Oh, good.
It's really and truly entertaining. I think it's going to be something very new for Birmingham, and I think everybody's going to like it. We're very excited about it.
I don't recall anything like that in the recent future since I've been here.
No.
That's that important.
No, it hasn't. It really hasn't.
It will be good. It will be fine, and you'll start hearing more about it in the next couple of weeks, I guess.
Hey, you two guys are going to be on it. I mean, and judging from the fun we're having up here today.
Well, you talk about chemistry, you know? That's the word they keep saying. You have to have chemistry.
Chemistry.
So
right.
Very scientific.
We've been working on it in the lab.
That's right.
We have to take a break right now, but we'll be back shortly. Well, Donna says she only has one more thing to say and then she'll be through.
And then I'll shut up and get out of here and go on with your show. The one thing is, we are going to be doing a lot of our features on unusual type events and people and places and things. So we would love to hear from everybody in Birmingham and all over Alabama. If you've got an idea or somebody you think that would make a great PM feature, write us or call us and let us know, because they sure might. Because that's what we're going to be doing.
You should get some interesting letters and calls on that.
Yeah, I'm sure I will. Seriously, that is what we're looking for, so we'd like to hear from you.
What they pay us for.
Oh, seeking out the strange and unusual. Mm-hmm.
We do it just for the love of television, but they do pay us for it, and it seems only fair that we would recruit features to come in. So.
Well, Donna, I'm glad you could join us today.
I was
glad
very
you
happy to be
could,
here.
You know, parry back and forth and have a chance to
it's
give
not,
us a preview of
it's
what's
not
going
parrying,
on.
It's chemistry.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Very scientific show.
Chemistry
is everything here.
Chemistry, yes. Well, all right. Mike, you're going to tell us what's coming up next. Or what little, we know, we don't go have gone out and filmed a live feature, but tape, pardon me, I keep getting corrected for that, it is tape, but you are going to tell us what's coming up next.
Well, somebody sure better.
Yes, because...
May as well be me as anybody,
I guess. The tongue's not working.
Hi, I'm Mike Sampson, and welcome to the very first edition of PM Magazine.
It sure is, and we hope we're going to be seeing you here every night at 6:30 for what we think is a completely new and different type of television show for Birmingham and Alabama. We'll be taking you all the way across the state and just about everywhere else, for that matter.
What a great idea. We'll be on the go looking for what's different, for what's unusual, for what's just a little bit odd, the kind of things you may not see anywhere else.
We'll also have special tips for you every night on home, health, travel. We call them our PM Magazine departments. They'll be in the middle of every show, and some nights we'll be taking you all the way across the nation, sometimes the world, and show you some special places that you might want a vacation.
I'm packed and ready. Some nights we'll spend the evening at home. We'll have a chef in the kitchen, a decorating expert in the living room, and a plant man in the garden. Tonight we're on Morris Avenue in downtown Birmingham at a tavern called Mules. In a couple of minutes. You know, Donna said she'd be here by now, and it's not really like her to be late. She should be here any minute or so. Well, let me tell you about tomorrow night's show while we're waiting. First, we're going to take you to a real brawl. I'm talking battle here. We're going to a tough guy contest right here in Birmingham. Then we're going to a special party for ladies only, a living room lingerie party. Now, that, of course, all assumes that Donna gets here sometime soon. As a matter of fact, she's here now. Let's go talk to her. Well, how about it, big guy? Did you have a good time?
Hey, had a great time. I'll tell you what, for this kid from now on, full wheel variety. Have you ever tried an 18-wheeler?
once. Only once and never again.
It was your turn, and it's your turn to do the driving right now, too.
I'm ready.
Around to your side of the car. But for Mike and myself and the PM staff, we hope you enjoyed the show half as much as we did. We'll see you tomorrow night at 6:30, and in the meantime, have a nice evening. Bye-bye.
Any of the stories you see here on PM, we'll tell you who to get in touch with for the information. Just send us a note along with a self-addressed stamped envelope to PM Magazine, Post Office Box 6, Birmingham, 35201.
Alabama. It's time for the morning show, live from the First Alabama Bank building on the Birmingham Green with Tom York, Colleen Bates, and Bill Bolin.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the morning show, the 26th day of September. It's a Friday, and again, we're live on the sidewalk in front of the First Alabama Bank.
TV6 presents the Saturday Night Movie. Tonight, Philip Carey and Darren McGavin star in The Great Sioux Massacre.
WHNT Television, Channel 19, Huntsville.
WHNT TV, the Tennessee Valley's leading news station, presents Action News Tonight.
Tonight is our first night on our new set, and we thought we'd take this opportunity to show you how we moved from our old facility.
Ever since the first day, nearly 10 years ago, when Ted Turner bought a small, struggling Atlanta independent TV station, this has been our home, 1018 West Peachtree Street. As the superstation grew over the years, more and more people and more equipment were crammed into this tiny building, and the old house next door, and the office building down the street. No doubt about it, it was a mess. And then about a year ago, Ted announced plans for the 24-hour cable news network. Well, there was no way all of that could fit into these facilities. So plans were drawn up for a new building, a new headquarters for the Turner Broadcasting System that would house cable news, the TBS corporate offices, and most importantly of all, the superstation. Here it is, the new headquarters of the Turner Broadcasting System. This building used to be an old in-town club with huge ballrooms and swimming pools. In a remarkably short time, construction crews rebuilt and remodeled the building into one of the most sophisticated television production centers in the world. Let's take a look. One of the first things you notice on the outside is the Dish Farm, a series of six receive and transmit satellite dishes that gathers news from all over the world for the cable news network and, of course, for the TBS Evening News. Here we are on the third floor. This is the floor which houses the TBS corporate offices. Ted's office is just down there at the end of the hall, next to Executive Vice President Robert Wessler. Some of the other people's names on this floor won't be as familiar to you, but each of these people, in his or her own way, is responsible for all the programs you see on TBS or CNN. Now let's go down to the first floor. Now, for those of you who receive the news channel on your cable system, this will be familiar to you. Here it is, the home of the cable news network. One of the nice things about the building is that it's efficiently designed. In the case of CNN, everything has a place. Newsroom studio, control room close to the action, and perhaps most conveniently of all, right above the CNN newsroom, on the second floor, are the WTBS studios and control rooms, our new home.
This big room will be absolutely full of people in about a week's time, full of directors, producers, and writers working on programs like Superstation Fun Time and the new Bill Tush program, which we'll be seeing later this winter. In fact, all of the programs produced at WTBS will be produced from this very room, all except for the TBS Evening News. We have our own little home. These rooms here are the control rooms involved with actually putting WTBS on the air. They hit a button, and a movie starts. Another button, and the TBS News studio is on the air. Incidentally, our largest production studio isn't used for news. Here it is. It measures 40 feet by 100 feet, and much of the programming you'll see on WTBS will be recorded here. Children's programming, special programs, comedy, variety, it'll all come from here. And as never before, we're prepared to do just about anything. Most of our studio and control room equipment is brand new and state-of-the-art. Now, I've been saving what we feel is the best for last, the TBS News Studio. It's right here. For the first time, the TBS Evening News and Newswatch broadcasts will have an entire studio and control room all to themselves. Not only that, the studio will also double as a work area for producers, directors, writers, and artists to bring you what we feel is a better TBS Evening News. Each night, Kevin and I will be here on the new set, next to the control room, and next to late-breaking news. So that's our new home. We've been frantically moving and hurriedly working to finish it all. That's why 1 week ago, this room looked like this.
And tonight, it looks like this. Kevin and I will be back tomorrow night at 10:15 Eastern Time. In the meantime, have a very good evening.
TBS Evening News has come to you from Atlanta, Georgia. With reports from the worldwide bureaus of Cable News Network, this is TBS Evening News with David Allen Jensen and Kevin Christopher with sports.
On Election Day, the Action News team will cover the state as never before to bring you the most complete election coverage in Alabama. Pam Huff and I will be here at the Channel 13 Election Center. NBC will provide us with national returns, and the Action News team will be with the candidates. Marla Miller will be in Mobile at the Denton headquarters.
I'm Teresa Racine, and I'll cover the Folsom headquarters in Montgomery.
I'm Denise Cannon. Steve Sanders and I will cover the race for the U.S. Representative from the 6th Congressional District. I'll be with Albert Lee Smith.
And I'll be at the Pete Clifford headquarters, both here in Birmingham.
I'm Rosemary Lucas, and I'll cover the Reagan-Bush headquarters.
And I'm John Harris. I'll be at the Carter Mondale campaign headquarters.
So join us here at Channel 13 for complete election coverage.
Election returns with live coverage from across the state. SkyCam reports in the Action News 13 team, beginning at 5, only on Channel 13.
This is a Total News election update.
Predicted at 7:57 this evening, Albert Lee Smith has won.
The Mobile Hilton, David Paulson, Total News.
This is Bruce Burkhardt in Montgomery.
From Campaign 80, Mary Gaines, Total News.
I'm Lee Mays reporting live from Pete Clifford headquarters.
November calendar, happenings, recipes, and events of interest to everyone with Sandra McNabb. Monday on December calendar, bringing the real beauty out of wood.
Taller than we stood. We know where you're coming from, cause we come from here too. And singing is believing that together we're here looking good.
Good things to share, good friends are there. Looking good together. Looking good together, looking good, looking good. Looking good together, looking good, looking good. You're at Channel 18, you're looking good.
Good afternoon, I'm Steve Alvarez. I'm at the home of Gary Gross, a gentleman who spent a number of years as a special aide to the White House as a film photographer under Presidents John Kennedy and Lyndon Johnson. I'll have an interview with him coming up next, live at 5.
Hi, I'm Glenn Brack, and I'll have a look at the weather satellite and Baton Rouge radar next on Live at 5.
I'm Mike Cannington. I'll have a report on cheap flights for Huntsville residents next, live at 5.
I'm Tony Troiano. South Carolina's George Rogers runs away with this year's Pigskin Oscar, next on Live at 5.
And I'm Jenny Thompson. We'll also talk live with Roy Brown, who is in ARAB, waiting for the results of labor negotiations at the ARAB co-op. Steve will show you how you can learn to fly in one day, and we'll talk about civilian employee evaluations at Redstone Arsenal. All that coming up next, Live at 5.
This is Live at 5, North Alabama's only live news magazine featuring the people, places, and events of the Tennessee Valley with Steve Alvarez and Jenny Thompson.
Good afternoon. I'm Jenny Thompson. I'd like to welcome you to Live at 5, a show we hope you'll find different and exciting as we not only update you on news of the day, but introduce you to some of the nice neighbors of Channel 48 all across the Tennessee Valley. Stay tuned for John Chancellor on the NBC Nightly News.